Welcome back to my channel once again. Now, congratulations first of all to all those who cleared both the written and the interview examination. So, in this video, I'll be covering that what's next after clearing out the UPSC CMS examination. But before starting that, let me clear out that the four things I'll not be covering in this video, wait for the next part. That is your medical examination which was pending, document verification, the reserve list and the provisional list. So, wait for the next part. So, let's start. This time they have given you two categories, category 1 and category 2. Category 1 means CGHS and category 2 means Railway, MCD, Ordinance. So, category 1 people are clear that they are going to join the CGHS. But category 2 people are still unsure that in which department they are going to be posted. So, your confusion will be clear within 3 to 4 months. You have to wait for a period of 3 to 4 months and you will be getting a mail and a post in which you will be specifying that you are allocated Railway, Railway, MCD, Ordinance. So wait for the 3 to 4 explaining you the joining process and the whole process which you have to go through in detail one by one. Let me start with the Railway cadre. Railway cadre, the whole process take around 8 months to 1 year. Like you have been, your result has came out. And since then, since 2 year joining, the period will be of 8 months to 1 year. That means the confusion you are going through that if I am clearing the NEET PG this year, then is that result going to interfere this joining? Then not at all. You will be giving the NEET PG. You will even join, and your period of that duration of doing PG will also cover some. Then, but you are not clear about the Railway. Okay. So, about the Railway. Railway, your joining process is going to take 8 months to 1 year. Then the worry which you all are worried about is that the NEET PG result came, NEET PG result this paper will be held late, or the result would came late and your joining comes early, then it's impossible. Okay, 8 months to 1 year it will take, because this period has been during when the COVID was not there. COVID has hampered it much more and the time period has increased even to the 1.5 years. So, the result is not going to be early. So, be sure you can freely give your NEET PG exam, check it out. If your result is good, you can leave the seat. Now, the Railway. First of all, you will get a mail within 3 to 4 months that you have been allocated Railway cadre and a post too. So if some people complains that my address has been changed, which I have mentioned, so I'll not be receiving that post. So for them, email is also giving the equal importance. If you have not got that letter through post, but you have got an email, then it's equally valid. But if you have changed your address, but that post is going to go to that address also, so from that speed post man, you are going to get a call that ma'am, you have a post there. So in my case, address was also changed. So I approached that postman that you send me personally that letter, I'll pay you whatever it cost. So you can do that also and get your letter at a new address. Now, you have got a letter that you have been allocated Railway, then your training start from the Vadodara. You all applicants from all area, those who have got Railways, you have to reach Vadodara for the training period, and the training period is of 2.5 months. During that, you will be getting salary, you will be getting accommodation, every benefit you will be getting there. Okay, so you have to complete a 2.5 months training there. Till then, you will not be informed that which zone you are going to get, or which area or which locality or which state or which place you are going to work. You will be completely unaware of it. You just have to do the training period. After completing that 2.5 months training period, you are going to be allotted a zone. There are total 17 zones in which you are going to be allotted a zone, wherever the vacancy is all about. So you get a zone. Now, when you get a zone, suppose you got a north zone, then of that zone you have to contact to the chief medical director of that zone. If you everyone has to reach whatever zone they get to the chief medical director. When you go to that chief medical director, suppose you got a north zone and you have to reach their chief medical director, then they are going to allocate then which city you are going to work. Till then you are unaware, you are just going to know that which zone, and that chief medical director is going to allot you the city. and your final posting will be done. Now, the question is, the railway is a probation period. Probation period in railway is of 1 year, which will be including your 2.5 months training. Okay, now the question is that you have done your training 2.5 months and you have joined also, but you leave before completing the 1 year process. So yes, you will be charged in that case. You have to return all the salary you will be receiving within 1 year, plus extra charge you have to pay for the training you received at the Vadodara center. So if you are joining railway, then be sure not to leave it before 1 year, otherwise you have to pay the whole 1 year salary and that probation period training cost you have to pay. Now the other thing is EOL for the leave which you get for the PG is not allowed now. EOL is permitted before, but now a new concept has been launched, and that is about the railway board extension. That means you have to approach to the railway board and you have to give an extension that, sir, I have to go for the PG, please permit the extension. In that case extension, your job is not sure. Again, after completing that PG course, if you come back, then you have to go through the offer letter revive process. Your offer letter, the previous you got, will not be allowed your job on that basis. Now your offer letter is going to revive again. So that EOL which you used to get easily is not now. You have to approach the railway board for the extension. If they permit, then you go. But it's not easy now. Okay. Then the police verification process. In the railway cadre, police verification is done after joining. So you don't have to wait for the police verification. Once you join there, then the police comes there. Okay. So don't worry about the police verification in the case of railway zone. I think I'm clear about the railway zone. Now switch on to the MCT code. MCT cadre, Municipal Corporation of Delhi. What we are going to do there? Okay. Again, 3-4 months, email and post. You are going to get email and post that you have been allotted a municipal. 3 months, you are going to get a mail, not any speed post. You are going to get a mail. So my advice to all the selected aspirants is, once a day check your email. Everything will be there on the email, so don't miss out any day not checking that email. So please keep on checking that mail. So you are going to get a mail that you have to fill a choice what Municipal Corporation of Delhi cadre you want, north, east or south. And that letter comes only for the 2 days that valid, that you have to choose within 2 days, north, east or south. After that, if you have missed that opportunity, not chosen any cadre, then by random they allocate you any cadre. And you can't blame on that I want to choose that again. You have to accept what they give you. Now, in the month starting, 2-3 months, you get that letter. Then in the that month end, you are going to get a mail and the post that finally, among three, you have been allocated this cadre, like east, north or south, whatever you got. Now, I got that letter in the month of June end. After doing all that process, you have to again wait for a 5 months period. After 5 months, you are again going to get a mail and a letter at your home. That mail would be specifying that within a period of month, you have to reach to Delhi, that head commissioner, like if East, suppose, to East Delhi headquarter, you have to reach there. There, they will give you a attestation form, 3 sets, you have to fill that up, attestation form. Second thing is, you have to again verify all your documents, and that is a basic that you have accepted that letter and basic a mean of reporting there. It is not allowed by through mail. You have to personally reach them and show all your documents and go through all this process. That time your medical examination will be done. So MCT cadre medical examination will be doing during that time. When you report them, everything is cleared, you submit them the attestation form, then they give you the medical form which you have to go the next day. So go for the medical examination, within 1 day it is over. In the medical examination, your process is over in the Delhi. Then after completing medical examination, you don't have to report back to the headquarter. You have to go home. Then your police verification step is going to take place. पुलिस वेरिफिकेशन फॉर्म्स विल बी सेंड बाय दोस ईडीएमसी क्वार्टर, ईडीएमसी हेडक्वार्टर, व्हाट एवर क्वार्टर हेडक्वार्टर यू आर गोइंग टू रीच. सो दे आर गोइंग टू सेंड द पुलिस वेरिफिकेशन फॉर्म टू द पुलिस डायरेक्टली. यू जस्ट हैव टू वेट फॉर द पुलिस टू कम होम एंड वेरीफाई योर पर्सनैलिटी एंड योर एड्रेस एंड ऑल. सो पुलिस वेरिफिकेशन विल बी डन एट द टू प्लेसेस, वन वेर द होम टाउन इज एंड द अदर वेर हैव यू डिड योर एमबीबीएस फ्रॉम. इफ सपोज यू डिड बोथ फ्रॉम द सेम प्लेस देन द वन पुलिस वेरिफिकेशन इज इनफ फॉर यू. सो पुलिस वेरिफिकेशन प्रोसेस इज गोइंग टू टेक 2 to 3 months. ओके, सो यू कैन डू एनीथिंग इन दैट. यू हैव टू वेट फॉर द पुलिस वेरिफिकेशन स्टेप टू बी कम्प्लीट. देन ओनली आफ्टर द पुलिस वेरिफिकेशन डन फ्रॉम बोथ द प्लेसेज, आफ्टर अ वीक यू हैव टू अगेन कॉल दैट ईडीएमसी ऑफिस और वट एवर ऑफिस यू हैव. देन दे विल अगेन सेंड यू आफ्टर 1 week अ लेटर, अ फाइनल लेटर दैट येस all your process has been completed. Finally they are giving you that letter that you have been joined with verifying you from all the places with your documents, medical examination, police verification, and you can please come and join. Then they are going to give you a period of 15 months for joining. In such cases, if you can't join or reach there within 15 months, then you have to personally message a valid reason to, you have to email them that you can't reach within 15 days, you need extension of 5 to 10 days, then they grant you. Okay, so when you reach there after that 15 days, within 15 days, then your job starts and you start getting your job and salary and everything. Talk about the ordinance. Now the third category is ordinance, in which you are going to get your letter within the 6 months to 1 year. Once you get that letter, you have to join within a 1 month. If you want your extension, then you have to send them a valid reason through a mail that you can't be joining due to this reason. So it depends on them whether they pursue that reason or not and give you a grant your leave. So within 1 month you have to join. Where you have to go is all the ordinance candidates which are selected in the ordinance, they have to go to the Kolkata head office for the appointment. They'll get an appointment there in the Kolkata head office. Then by getting that, they have to contact the GM, like the hospital CMO, where they are going to be allocated. That hospital CMO, known as GM, you have to all contact them. Then after contacting them, that okay, you are going to join this particular college. Then after going all that process, you have to go for the training to Nagpur. Your training process is going to be completed in Nagpur. Like in railway, the training is in Vadodara, but in ordinance, your training will be done in the Nagpur. After the training period of 1 month, you have to reach the respected place where you have contacted the GMO and joined at that college. So, in ordinance, the medical examination. Now, medical examination in the case of ordinance is when you got that joining letter, then you have to send them a mail. You have to email that your about your medical examination. Your medical examination, you have to go and complete your medical examination from the place you belong to or at present you are residing in. There's no particular restriction that you have to go to medical examination in that particular hospital. Wherever you are, you can go medical examination complete from that place and mail them. So your medical examination is completed in the case of ordinance through that process. Now, the last is the CGHS category. It is the fastest of all. Like every month takes 8 months to 1 year for the joining, but it is the fastest of the all. But I don't have much knowledge about that. Don't know the process in detail about the CGHS. So I would recommend you that please keep on checking your mail daily so that you don't miss out anything on it. Sorry for not having knowledge about CGHS in detail about the joining process. So please check on mail. In the last, I would summarize the most important point is please check your mail daily. You will be informed much before any process from any cadre. Just check your mail. You don't need anyone that what is going to be the next. Check your mail. Whatever they do, go through that. And the 4 important things which I mentioned earlier in this video, I'll be covering in my next video. So don't miss any video or any, So I would recommend you, please listen to this video seriously. Don't miss any point because it can cost you. I hope all the best. Stay safe. Stay healthy. All the best.